Good morning, children. In our previous video, we started with the chapter 3 of Social and Political Life. Why do we need a parliament? We have discussed about why India opted for parliamentary form of government, why should people decide who will form the government, and how do people give approval to the government. Now let us proceed further. What does parliament consist of? The parliament consists of the president, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The Lok Sabha is called the House of the People. This is because its members are elected directly by the people. The Lok Sabha cannot have more than 552 members. Out of these, 530 members are elected from the states and 20 members are elected from the union territories. Seats are allotted to each state on the basis of its population. The President of India can nominate 2 members from the Anglo-Indian community if he feels that the community is not adequately represented. The members of the Lok Sabha are elected for a term of 5 years. The Speaker supervises the proceedings and maintains order in the House. Next is the Rajya Sabha. The Council of States or the Rajya Sabha is the upper house of the parliament. There can be maximum of 250 members in the Rajya Sabha, out of which 238 members represent the states and the union territories. Members of the state legislative assemblies elect members of the Rajya Sabha. The Vice President is the presiding officer or chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Now let us discuss about the function or the role of the parliament. The main important function of the parliament are to select the national government, to control, guide and inform the government, and the third one is making of the laws. Let us start with the first one. For this, the country is divided into different constituencies, then the elections are conducted, and the party which gets the maximum number of seats forms the government. The next majority party forms the opposition. The speaker is elected from the ruling party. The prime minister is the leader of the ruling party. He selects the minister to work with him to implement the laws. At present, the single party did not get a chance to form the government. Do you know why? Because the single party did not get a proper majority to form a government. So, they joined together and formed a coalition government. Second is to control, guide and inform the government. Generally, the first hour of a sitting of Lok Sabha is devoted to questions, and that hour is called as a question hour. During this period, the minister answers questions sent in advance by various MPs. Debates over the queries and replies help to reveal flaws in the government's policies. The second is a zero hour. The time between the question hour and the beginning of the rest of the day's work is known as the zero hour. The zero hour is important because debate over issues of public interest are held during this period. The third is the making of the laws. About this, we will discuss in detail in the next chapter. The next and the last topic is, who are the people in the parliament? Children, now we have more and more participation of people from different backgrounds, like women, Adivasis, Dalits and minorities. This happened due to seat reservation. Our country can be called as truly democratic country only when there is maximum participation of people from different backgrounds. This is the end of the chapter. Holiday homework will be posted soon on your class WhatsApp group. Thank you.